Hi Cancer, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. And this is your monthly forecast for September 2012. Cancerians, we have a Sun and a Mercury transit this month. And it's going to be transiting your third house. That is a house that has to deal with higher mind, consciousness, communication, and some amount of our travel. You're going to be activating your surroundings, your neighborhood, group activities, and it seems that you're going to be involved in a lot of seminars and workshops. This house is ruled by the busy Mercury, representing that communication of any form, be it through emails, be it verbal, that is making presentations or presenting your ideas across the board to people. It also speaks of SMSs, contracts, and signing papers, you know, contractual agreement. It also covers your broadcast radio, and it's a great time for those of you who are involved into the media space, that there would be great opportunities that would come your way. Cancerians, we have with the Mercury and the Sun transit, it is a great time where you are going to be broadening your mental horizons. I think the planetary aspects are such that it would be very conducive. The environment is going to be very conducive for you to network. So whether you consciously go out and seek advice, expert advice, or groups of people or not, the opportunities will come to you quite naturally, either through work or either through the your own community as to where it is that you live. It speaks of larger groups of people surrounding you as well. So it's a good time to be sharing your thoughts, your ideas, your values, your projects, and they would be received quite well. You may have a sense of being involved, and not just in your projects, but in projects which could have to do with your acquaintances or with your business partners as well. So you may not be initiating projects, but you may be called upon to give your expert advice as well. Considering on the love aspect, this is the month wherein you are going to be feeling slightly alienated. Some of you could feel a bit unloved, you know, they could be I think it's more so stemming from an issue of self-worth as to whether it is or not that you deserve to be loved. As to, you may have a sense of being unloved or a sense of unworthiness. This is merely a squaring effect. Planets, when they square, one is a trining or one is a conjunct in a combustible aspect, and whenever two planets square, it's really a bit of a friction or a slightly challenged time. So this time you should be aware that it's just a temporary phase, you know, it's more of a transitory effect that is the planets have on you, rather than really a long-term effect of you feeling or reacting in a certain way. New opportunities, I would say, around the first week would come by, and they need to be reviewed carefully. Every time that there is a squaring of a planet, it's a great time not to rush into things, not to commit things, not to sign contracts, but to sit and review your plan, sit and look at the clauses that are there, the repercussions that it could have. It's a good time to be sitting and doing that. Also, you may feel in your ability to deal with people, you may feel a bit restrictive, or you may feel that people are not really responding to you or not really opening up to you. And again, I'm reiterating, this is merely a transitory effect. It has nothing to do on a long-term piece of it, and this is around the second week of September that you will be having a sense that socially you're not being very well accepted, or you are not really maybe as gregarious or as open as you normally are in a social scenario. You yourself may feel quite restricted as far as communication is concerned, or you may not really be wanting to go out and seek company and be with people. Also understand that this could also stem from a reaction coming from you. You could be what it is that we call in astrology a mirroring effect. So you could actually be sending signs off unconsciously that you don't want to be approached, or you're not open to certain ideas, and people could just be reacting to you over there. Venus early week enters your house of earned income, and it's a happy position for Venus. Venus is a goddess of love, beauty, sex and money, so she's quite happy being in your sector, which has to do with your earned income. With Venus entering your second house, that's a house of earned income, the scenario will change for you. You will be attracting a lot of friends on your side, and the earned income, besides focusing on the material wealth, it also speaks the richness and the goodness of having good friends. So you will find friends who will actually get together and not just pull up your spirits, but you could also find a friend who's very, very generous to you and may just offer you a very lucrative business deal, or a great business opportunity may come to you through a very dear friend. So this week, it's a good time to be attracting lots of gifts and goodwill gestures to yourself. For those of you who are very much in love and are in a deeply committed relationship, it's a great time for you to be popping the question if you've been thinking for the longest time whether or not you should be getting married, or you've been sitting and mulling about it. It's a great time for you to be taking your relationship on to the next level. Pluto at this time is in your seventh house, and that is something is Pluto is going to make you look at your committed relationships very closely. And it is also, besides your love piece of it, you will also be looking at your committed business partnerships as well. And this seems to be a time where things will be sort of smoothing out for you. So you will be finding it simpler and easier to be dealing with business partners with whom you are there in a legal binding, so to speak. Or if you've been involved in putting up of a contract and you've been been negotiating and trying to put the paperwork together, this is a time when you will be able to do it without too many glitches. It will become quite smooth for you. However, with the focus again being on your relationship sector, it's asking you really to look at the patterns that you've had in relationships before. Try not to operate from a space of fear, Cancerians. Try not to assume things, look at people, look at relationships the way that they have been in the past, and then operate. I think it's very important that the lesson for you this month is to try and change your ideas, try and move out of your comfort zone. And for a Cancerian especially, it is quite difficult, because crabs, they find change quite hard. They hold their dear and their loved ones very, very close to themselves, and they like the tried and tested routine, and they give it far more importance than the risky and the adventurous side of life. But this time, as far as love is concerned and your relationships are concerned, the universe is urging you to let go of fear a bit, let go of your old set patterns, your thoughts, the way that you have been, or whether it has been your conditioning that has been there, or maybe so far what life has taught you or your experiences have been. Try not to operate out of them, and look at your newer relationships, or I would say that even not so new relationship, through the same glass. Try and have a fresher perspective and be open to change. It's very important for you. There is also a sense of deepening that you will find with somebody that you have recently met, and it could be somebody that you have met again through a friend, and seems to be very nice and a very interesting person. And when I'm saying recent, it could be a year, it could be about 6 months, and you could find yourself, you know, having a sense of a bond with this person, as if you've known this person for the longest of time. So you will be making an extra effort to not just look nice and be nice, but also you will be making an effort to in getting to know this person, and there will be a deepening of I think there's a lot of empathy between the two of you. You know, you there's a lot of unspoken things which both of you intuitively understand about the other. So, and with September, mid-September, you will sense, you know, that maybe this relationship has something more to it than just friendship. So it's a good thing. And the overall message for you, Cancer, in this month is to let go of fear. Try not to worry too much of the end result, be it at your work or be it at a personal relationship. Try not to write the script to the T, and you know, because it gives you great comfort to know as to what is it that how an X thing is going to be ending, or where it is that an X thing will lead you to. The universe is urging you very strongly to just let go and go with the flow and have faith in the universe. It is it will watch out for you, and only it's asking of you is that try not to be in the same rut of thoughts and patterns and conditioning from where that you've operated all along. And while yes, it's a hard task, I think somewhere that if you keep checking yourself that this is now how you're going to be reacting, or this is not how bad, I think half the time the problem is that you are maybe assuming the worst, or you've already assumed the worst even before the situation or something has got manifested, or even about people. You're so sure that somebody is going to let you down that invariably, I think somewhere you quite intend quite strongly for it. So this month, try and let go of the patterns. It's a great opportunity of letting go of old ideas, old thoughts, old beliefs, in approaching not just relationships but also your business ventures. Try to look at your old problems with a newer perspective, and if somebody comes up to you with a fresher way to approach things, be more open to it before you sort of just dismiss it and saying, oh, I know it's not going to be working for me. Be more fluid. And I think the important thing is that try not to resist so much to change. I think it just hurts more when you are making that extra effort that you're not going to be changing. So just let go this month and have faith in the universe. So overall, a great month for you, Cancerians. I'll see you again in October, and thank you so much for watching.